my life I wanted to be a Lola Falana.
Everybody knows who he is. But do you know who she is?
That's me, Michele Mello Yello Jennings. This is my life as an MC Hammer dancer.
My question for my aunt Michele is, how did her and MC Hammer actually meet? And I was wondering, what did he see in my auntie that made him pick her to be one of his dancers?
Okay, well, here it is. My friend Charlisa's aunt found out that Hammer was looking to audition new girls for his new tour. And we went down to Fremont, California. Hammer asked, "Do you have anything to try out in or rehearse in? Change clothes?" He said, "Learn the routine." We picked up the routine like that. And that night he was like, I guess he was a little frustrated or something. He was like, "Can you guys move down tonight?" I was like, "Let me just go talk to my parents. I just graduated high school. I just need to, you know, let them know what's going down." And needless to say, the next day, I moved into an apartment with four other girls. And that was the start of the MC Hammer Dancers torture. And then you knocked me off my feet. It was a live broadcast for a show called MTV Spring Break Daytona Beach and on Daytona Beach. And I tell you, when we hit that stage, it was incredible. It was such a high. I felt like I was on top of the world. At that moment, I did not realize who I was dancing for.
I mean, she could cut up even to this day in 05, and just in thinking back, she'll dance with like anybody. Like, we were at a party in LA, some after party at a club that Prince used to own called the Grand Slam. And all of a sudden, you know, there was commotion. I had lost her in the club for a little while. And I mean, it was big stars, you know, like Wesley Snipes and all that. She's in the middle of the floor dancing with Webster. And I mean, they both was at it like none other. It was amazing though. But I mean, she's so loving and kind, you know. And I mean, who, you know, you think of Webster's, like, who's gonna dance with? They was cutting up. So she's a ball of joy. She's one of the best dancers I've ever seen.
Phone conversation is good, but it's better when you have your sister around in person that can help you make decisions and lead you in the right directions, especially when you look up to them. So it was hard.
The Soul Train Awards, and being able to watch these awards, I used to like go to school and brag to different people. You know, I ain't too famous. She danced with MC Hammer. You know, that made me the top dog at school, the man, you know? Because my auntie, she was on TV.
Wow. Like, can't explain. It's just not really explain. It's like everybody's dream come true.
All the time he talked about his relationships with his dancers were like his kids. They were part of his family. They still are part of our family. They learned a lot from him in the early years of their careers. Some of them have gone on to become choreographers, actors, dancers, and now Michele is going to be directing and doing some acting herself. So he keeps them in mind. He talks about them all the time. They keep in touch. They know he's there for them whenever they need him, and vice versa. So it's just been a it's been a wonderful relationship with all of them, but Michelle especially for me.
When I started dancing with MC Hammer, I was about 17. I was going through this rebellious stage of my life. I wanted to see things. You know, we travel into different countries. I wanted to see the country, savor the culture. But because Hammer was such a father figure and very protective, he would assess fines if we would, you know, just wander off by ourselves or if we hung out past curfew. And I would get charged so much. It got so bad to where Hammer was like, you know what, just give her money back. It's not that I was trying to be a hardhead, but I just wanted to enjoy the time away from my familiar surroundings. I'm not gonna sit here and act like everything was good all the time, because it wasn't. I remember this time when we were on our way to a video shoot and two of the dancers decide to stop at the mall and get two sexy outfits. Lo and behold, Hammer liked the outfits. I had no time to go to the mall. As a result, I was not featured in the infamous video Pumps in the Bumps. So you know what I did? I broke an unwritten rule never to work with any other artists. I flew to Seattle, Washington. I was featured in Sir Mix-a-Lot's video, Put 'Em on the Glass. I performed in a pink bikini, something I would never do. This was the one thing that pissed Hammer off. He got over it.
We have tons of memories together, flying all over this country, touring with TLC, Boys to Men. We had just a ball with them. One time, Michelle dressed up like Left Eye on stage. And just pissed them off, and just that cat stuff that girls do, and it was just, it was amazing, you know, but we stood our ground, and I'm sure that, you know, they'll never forget those days as well.
I bet you're wondering if there were any romances on the road. Of course there was. Hammer was real strict about us dating on the road. He wanted us to have an untouchable reputation, which we did. But there was one guy that he gave me the thumbs up on, and that was Wanye from Boys to Men. And Wanye, he was such a good guy. And that was my road dog. We were real cool together. And the other side of him, he was such a romantic kind of guy. He would send me teddy bears. He would send me candy, flowers. He would write me poems and songs and send me cards and call me his streak of yellow from sports. I remember this time where he was trying to impress me or something, and he rented out the whole movie theater so that we can watch the movie Boomerang. That was so impressive and so sweet. Life on the road. You think you know? You have no idea.
Yeah!
That That's cool. Let me see you guys dance. Yay! Yeah. Sorry.
There you go.
No, that's not working.
Yeah. Thank you.
Right.
Okay.